Do you want to make money in your business? Of course! Why even start a business if you're not going to make money? However, most of the time, how much we want to make does not line up with how much we're really going to make. So in this video, I'm going to teach you how to be consistent with how much you want to make and how much you will really make. This is Lisa Mackey, and I help driven people like you start and build a successful small business. In that video, I talked about the steps in starting a successful small business. This video is a continuation of the financial planning part of that video, so you may also want to watch that. So how do you maintain the consistency between how much you want to make and how much you're really going to make? The answer is in planning wisely. There is a reason why lenders and investors are very interested in the financial part of your business plan. Lenders want to know if you can really pay back what you borrowed, and investors want to know the return on their investment. And even if you're not going to borrow money, or even if you don't need investors, I still recommend that you create a business plan, specifically the financial part of the plan, because this will help you to plot your course wisely. When you have your financial plans in place, then your marketing efforts will be more profitable. It's all about the plan. This is where it begins. What you learn in this video is a simple and an uncomplicated way of creating your financial projections. Now, as your business grows, and depending on the type of business you have, you will need to expand your projections to include more items. But what I'm going to teach you are the basic steps in creating your financial projections. There are three main things to include in your financial projections: your projected sales, your projected expenses, and the pricing. All these three are connected together. So let's start with your projected sales. Now, how much sales you want to make will depend on how much you want to earn. So for simplicity's sake, let's do a one-year projection from the time that you expect to make sales. So that would be around 6 months after the actual start of your business, which means that you have already introduced it to the public. You're actually running your business. And that is if you planned and prepared well for your launch and for your start. Incidentally, this is how BSFY will help you. So if you sign up for BSFY, you will learn how to plan well for your launch and your start so you can earn the money you expect to earn. So you can check the link in the video description after watching this video. So let's say that you want to make $10,000 a month on your first year. So the next questions would be, how do you expect to earn that money? Where is that money going to come from? And how many customers and clients do you need to make that happen? So let me answer those questions one by one. The first two are connected. How do you expect to earn that, and where is it going to come from? So I'm going to use a small life coaching business as an example here. So let's say that 50% of your sales target, which is $5,000, will come from your group coaching services, and the other 50% will come from your one-on-one coaching services. So looking at this example, it will be easier for me to figure out how many clients and or customers will I need to make it happen or to achieve my sales targets. However, it's going to be very challenging to convert the sales targets as to the exact number of customers I need without the pricing. So which means that when you get to this part of the business plan, you should already have your pricing in place. So going back to this example, I'm going to put a price tag on your services. Okay, so based on the percentage, 50-50 for group coaching and one-on-one coaching, so the group coaching sales is $5,000, so that will be at $700 per person for 3 months, because you have a three-month program. So that will convert to 21 new clients a month. Now, this is easy when you have an ongoing online program that students can just enroll in. As I mentioned in the previous video, the part one of this video, the hard part is always in the planning phase. Now, the one-on-one coaching is also $5,000. So let's say that you have a $2,500 per person program for 3 months. So that means you would need 6 new clients a month. Now, this is not going to be easy. So this is where you need to make the necessary adjustments. I just wanted to show you this so you can see the importance of your pricing to your sales targets. So you can either increase the price of your one-on-one coaching or focus more of your efforts on your group coaching. The key is to make the adjustments when necessary so that you can achieve your sales targets. So the other item I mentioned under financial projections is projected expenses. Now this includes both the pre-operating and the operating expenses. The pre-operating expenses are all your expenses before you even start your business. So this would include equipment, supplies, licenses, registrations, hiring a business coach, and everything else that you need to spend for before you actually run your business. Now, the operating expenses are your day-to-day expenses to maintain and run your business. So I want to focus on the operating expenses more than the pre-operating, although you would need both if you are creating your financial projections. But again, for simplicity's sake, I want to focus on the operating expenses. Now, if you borrowed money for your pre-operating expenses, then include your monthly payments in your operating expenses. So I wanted to create a list of everything that you will spend for to run and maintain your business. So let's say, again, for simplicity's sake, it's $10,000. Let's just say, no, not 10,000, but 5,000. So let's put your expenses, actual expenses, operating expenses to $5,000. And let's round that off to 6,000 to cover your taxes. So if your sales target is 10,000 and you have 6,000 in projected expenses, then that would still leave you $4,000 as a buffer. So if you really make that money and you really maintain that projected expenses, then you would still have $4,000 to reinvest back into your business or probably pay yourself a salary. So my purpose of showing you this is for you to understand the connection between your sales targets, your pricing, and your projected expenses in creating your financial projection. The key to having an alignment between how much you want to earn and how much you will really earn is in planning wisely. So if you follow the simple guide I gave you, you can make the necessary adjustments, whether it is from your pricing, your sales projection, or your projected expenses. My advice is for you to aim high, but realistically, more so in the beginning, so that you'll keep motivated, but not disappointed. When you set your targets too low, you will be complacent. When you set it too high, you will be overwhelmed. When you have clear directions to follow, you will be spending more wisely and planning more effectively, thereby guaranteeing the success of your small business. This is what Business School for You is designed for. When you sign up for BSFY, you will learn very clear steps on how to start and build your business successfully from the time of conceptualization to the time of launching towards the successful running of your business. And because it's an online program, you have the flexibility of time and space. You can do it anywhere, anytime. You can speed it up, slow it down, depending on your schedule. And because you have lifetime access, it's like having a coach with you forever. You can't beat that. So sign up now for BSFY. You can also find the link in the video description. Now, I want to hear your thoughts about this video. What was your biggest takeaway? Let me know in the comments below. I upload a new video every Wednesday, so hit that subscribe button and the bell so you'll be notified. Now, thank you so much for watching. I want to see you succeed in business because you deserve it.